So today's lesson looks at the greatest common factor and a few things for vocab to get us going. The factor, what it really means by factor, is I want to think of a factor as like the pieces, right? So my kids love doing Legos. All those different pieces look different, but those pieces come together to create a cool Lego thing, right? So in this case, our factors are our pieces that come together, they multiply together, and they create our polynomial, all right? So we have to make sure we can identify specific factors or specific pieces in today's lesson. So the greatest common factor is called a GCF, greatest common factor. And you actually learn this concept back in elementary and middle school, but we use it in a sense where it's algebraic. So a greatest common factor is going to be one where it's the biggest. Greatest doesn't mean like Muhammad Ali, I'm the world's greatest. Greatest means biggest, right? And then common means that it's something that all the terms in the polynomial have to have it in common, right? So you and I share certain things in common, and then some things that we don't have in common, right? So it has to be the biggest factor they all have in common. If you hear that word prime is when they really don't have anything in common except for the number one. Like most of us know that 3 and 7 are prime because the only numbers that they have in common are one, right? And the only factors that they have in common. But 4 and 2 are not prime because they have a number other than one in common. Okay, so there's some vocab for you to get you started. Give you a second to get that all filled in. Press pause if you need to. And what I'm going to introduce to you today is probably the single greatest idea. We're not going to cover it in its entirety today, but we're going to introduce it. The single greatest idea of algebra in Algebra 1, this Math 1, this first level of algebra. It's the idea of factoring. Factoring. And the reason why I say it's the single greatest thing is because you will factor in 9th grade, you will factor in 10th grade, you will factor in 11th grade, you will factor in 12th grade. You will factor for the rest of your math career. So it's really important that we learn how to do it. Well, what is it? Factoring is basically a very fancy word for division, okay? We're just dividing. It is division. It's dividing, or aka using the distributive property, but backwards, right? Because remember, distribution is multiplication. So division is now opposite of multiplication. That's what factoring really is it's division, all right? So the first thing we have to be able to do is to be able to identify what this thing called the GCF, the greatest common factor, actually is. So the GCF, you could write greatest common factor in those parentheses if you want to, but in order to identify it, here's what we have to do. We have to identify what they, when I say they, they means all the terms, okay? All the different terms. We have to identify what they all, right? What they all, not just some of them, all of them, what they all have in common, okay? So, this includes numbers and variables. It has to be the numbers, maybe 2, 4, 12. What number do they have in common, right? Maybe it's x squared and x. What do they have in common? So once we've identified what those things are, we're then going to write that GCF, and we'll practice this in a second, but we're going to write that GCF in front of the parentheses, all right, in front of the parentheses. So when we divide, it's basically going to be this idea of dividing out something, but we don't divide and throw it away. We divide and we put it in front of the parentheses. So you saw in the earlier video where we divided by something, and that kind of just disappeared. But in this case, it's not disappearing. We're going to use it. We're going to use that thing that we're dividing by, right? And then we Once we know what that GCF is, here's where the division comes in. We then divide each term by that GCF, and what remains is in the parentheses, right? So when you divide each term, what you get once you divide, it stays inside the parentheses. So you can, it's really important that you can identify the GCF by having every single term has to have it all in common. You then put it in the front of the parentheses, and then you divide every term by that so that you figure out what remains and what's left behind, and that stays inside the parentheses. You can always check your work by redistributing. So that's this process of what a GCF is. In the next video, we're going to actually practice identifying it, dividing, and then writing your answer in its final form.